So this game that we're switching over to, we are in the M's. It is the last letter of this evening, last game of this evening. Marvel Superheroes, War of the Gems. This was a game that I actually owned the cartridge for, and I loved this game. I mean, it's a little weird when you first start off, but once you get going, it's actually a really, really good game. And it follows the Infinity Gems, which with the situation the Marvel Cinematic Universe is setting up, this is a great game to be playing right now. Even though it's completely different. Let's do it. Let's see if I still remember how to do things. So, basically, the Infinity Gems have fallen to Earth, and Adam Warlock gets Earth's Mightiest Heroes to help. These are four possible locations that the first two gems could be in. We're gonna start with the Boston Aquarium. Nope, we're gonna start with the Boston Aquarium. Thank you. And these are the heroes I can choose. I always used to take Iron Man into the aquarium. But everybody plays a little differently. This screen I can't do anything with right now, but once I have an Infinity Gem or two, this will allow me to heal injured heroes. Damage is carried over from level to level, so these first two items here are healing items. This will allow me to use a gem special move, and this will allow me to revive a dead character. So essentially, the characters I have are also singular lives. So it's a really interesting system. Let's see. Pulsar Blast. Double jump. That thing. Okay. That's great. They put explosives in the aquarium. This game has some great Marvel characters in it, both good and bad. And basically, the Magus, however you pronounce his name, has created evil copies of a lot of characters. As you can see, my air is running out there. If it runs out, my health starts going down. Yeah, there's an evil Puck. The Pucks are annoying. Oh my gosh, are the Pucks annoying. This is actually a great beat 'em up game. With some good platforming elements in it, so. Made it to the elevator, which, even though the place was flooded over there, is full of air. Now, the orange containers here are immediate health pickups. I think that's an evil Adam Warlock? Or an evil Doctor Strange, one of the two. So with this and another game that's going to be far later down the list, two beat-em-up games that I owned as a kid that I just absolutely loved. The second one being X-Men Mutant Apocalypse. And it's on this list, so we will be playing it. We'll be far closer to the end of this project, but... full combos off on them because they take more damage that way. Otherwise, you waste a lot of time. Time is not something I have right now with a limited air supply. Extra gem thing. I don't have any gems, so I can't really use it. Evil Hawkeyes. Yay! Oh, and part of the reason I love bringing Iron Man to this stage? Evil Iron Man. Ah. Come off it. Once you take one of them out, they're actually not that bad. Unless that happens. Gosh. Well, Iron Man's dead. So, not really setting the best example of me owning this game as a kid. Who's good for this? Try Cap. Don't have any revive shields. Shield toss will be useful. It's nice I still remember how to make it go the different directions. Okay, what is that? Legs are so beefy. That does not go as fast as I had hoped. So that's not really going to be a time saver. His basic standing combo could hit pucks. Captain America hits a little high. So, if I lose Cap on the aquarium, we'll try a different level to get some variety going. There's a revive shield in Alaska that I know I can get. Come on. Let's do it to it, Steve. Let's go. Steve as in Steve Rogers, not Steve in the chat. Although I did have the thought of setting up net play with this emulator to try and get some multiplayer aspects going on. That may be a thought for another day. I mean, it may not be for this platformer project, but getting some online multiplayer Super Nintendo stuff going would be great. Donkey Kong, Mario, all that jazz. I will make some plans and see what I can do. Ooh! And this is why I like Iron Man's double jump. Because those things are obnoxious. Come on, almost there, almost there. There we go. I could have sworn there was something up there. See, if you can get them stuck together like this, it helps immensely. See, I just wiped them out completely. Probably should have done cap the first time. Hey, we got a gem. I don't remember what the original colors are, so I don't know which one that is. We'll find out in the menu. But out of the four stages, there's only two gems, and they are randomly placed every time you play, so... Alright, let's go ahead and go to Alaska. Let's take Wolverine here. Reality gem's gonna be nice to have, and we'll take a couple of those for in case I need them. Evil Daredevil and Evil Wolverine, look at that. Freaking hate the Evil Daredevils. That's part of the reason I used to take Wolverine here. Nope, not there. Okay. I could go through that wall and fight a mini-boss fight of a million and a half evil pucks. Or one evil puck, I can't report two. I honestly can't remember. Oh yeah, the whole enemy strike thing, yeah. Obnoxious! I think there's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game on this list. Check the link. I can't remember. There, got the revive shield, we can get Iron Man back. Evil Hawkeye's in a small place. It's obnoxious as all get out. Oh, come on. I know I can make this. Ha! Want that. Ah, here we are. Love that boss music. Evil Sasquatch! You would think it'd be Sabretooth, but no, it's Sasquatch. Oh, my wife wants something. Bad timing. Come on, Sasquatch. This fight's not too bad, though. Check that out later. Yeah, we got the other gem. Problem is, we still have to complete the other two levels. Actually, I got the same message on my phone. I can see what she needs. Yeah, I'll check it out later. Can't get there soon enough. Okay, so... it might be because it's a pure beat-em-up and not a platformer. I could have sworn there was one on here, but I guess not. Who did I used to do Doom's Castle with? Honestly, I think I used to use Iron Man. I could do Hulk, that'd be fun. Revive Iron Man here. Which gem did I get? Time gem. Move faster. Oh my gosh, Wolverine and Spider-Man with the time gem are fantastic. Let's see. Revive. There we go. This will actually help. Oh god, yes. Not off to the best start. Oh, come on, I had the other guy in the combo. Oh, what, Eric? Not a fan? This game is fantastic. DC game. I'm pretty sure all the good ones were back in the B's with the Batman game from the animated series. Which was a good game. I was just so terrible at that Joker fight. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, this path you kind of have to have Iron Man to take. Or one of the other climbers. Just got him back and I fall in a hole. Let's do Spider-Man. Ah! Let me go, God. I need that throat. So fast. Yeah, the lower path here is actually a lot more difficult. Okay, so that's what that was. Yep. Oh, come off it! I'm not that bad at this game. It's nice to actually see you. I was wondering if you were gonna make it. I actually had an early start this evening, can you believe that? Smack. Oh. Grab that. Revive shield. Started playing Darkest Dungeon. let's see. Yeah, I don't do a lot of damage. So I gotta play smart. Oh, I missed. Oh, that's right, Doom runs off. Player, stop! Yeah! Fancy pose! Last stage of the first set. The Amazon, I used to use Hulk. Of all things. Go ahead and revive Iron Man. Again. Give Hulk a speed gem because that's helpful. Smash! I was actually thinking of going a little longer and highlighting this specific portion. Because this is a fantastic game. I could go through this whole game. And we'll see. But yeah, Evil She-Hulks. Make the funniest noises. But yeah, this is Hulk with the time gem. Imagine how slow he is without it. Thank you. beat these freaking guys. Without the time gem, that would have been damn near impossible. Some of the moves. Ow. Oh yeah, I forgot I can actually break those. Come on. Yeah, we're getting closer to the Mega Man stuff. Oh man. The Mega Man X stuff is coming up Thursday if I play the cards right. Shield and don't jump high enough. Ugh. Now here's a question. Should I devote more time to Mega Man 7 since that comes before the X Games? So that I can do the X Trilogy in its own stream. Because tomorrow would be Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, Mooey Mallard and Cold Shadow, and Mega Man 7. If I wanted to give the X Games their own. Or I can skip the X Games. Play several games. And then go back to them on Friday. Or we could just end with like an hour of Mega Man 7. Hour and a half, because I don't expect Mary Shelley's Frankenstein to be any good, and Mooey Mallard is a great game, but it's also really big and confusing. I don't know. I'll get it figured out. I guess who did I... Oddly enough, Spider-Man. Okay, so, it wouldn't be a complete skip of the X Games, you know that. Although I could legitimately understand an actual unfollow for that. So you know what, tomorrow what we'll do is, yeah, we'll play the next couple games in the M's. Aww. But then we'll just finish the night out with long play of Mega Man 7. And then Friday will be the Mega Man X Trilogy. We'll do the Mega Man X Trilogy in a similar fashion to how I did the Donkey Kong Country Trilogy. We'll give each game about an hour. Which, for Mega Man X 1, should be all the more I need. Because my speedrun time was about an hour and 5 minutes. So. Oh god, Evil Hulk! I forgot about you. I speedrun all the X games. Well, for X1, I have a method for that. For the other two, Mega Man X2 especially, I cannot stand 2 out of the trilogy. It's just, it's awful compared to the rest. Ah! Come on, don't. Thank you. Ow. Doing so good there. Ugh. Forgot how that thing worked. I always thought it kind of looked like a clown. Who to use? Let's see if we can't find some extra items. Might be helpful. Last time. Surprised by him. Okay. That wasn't so bad. Okay, so it is settled. Tomorrow, I'll play the next two games, followed by Mega Man 7. We'll just finish out the night with Mega Man 7. And then we'll do the Mega Man X trilogy on Friday in the similar fashion to Donkey Kong Country. This simple for the purpose of keeping myself alive. That should not have hit me. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, I don't think that would have been there if I didn't have the reality gem. Oh, your hitbox annoys me. Revive shield and some health. Wonderful. Obnoxious. Yeah, the extra health items would not be here without the reality gem. Thankful for that. Probably would have survived with Spider-Man if I had that. I always want to give him speed, though. Same side of me. Stronger one. Because why not? Hey, take it easy, Eric, and thanks for popping in. Catch you tomorrow. No, not tomorrow, because tomorrow's Wednesday. I don't stream tomorrow. Catch you Thursday. Magus. Physical attacks still hurt. And that thing he was doing would have healed him. Alright. Let's go ahead and back out. Spider-Man again. As much as I like the time gem. Reality gems really useful. So much easier. Spider-Man's hitbox for his kick is so much nicer. Boom. See, if only you would get the power gem in the first set, because power gem increases your attack power. For Spider-Man, that's helpful. For someone like the Hulk, that's overkill. But the most beautiful variety. Spider-Man. That'll be helpful. I don't really need to go there then, do I? Oh. Let's speed this sucker up, shall we? This one's mandatory. Was actually pretty good at this game. Ah, that ball. Spider-Man can jump it so much easier, though. In most cases. Ah. Suck. Ah, no. I'm so close. Ah, so close. No! Got him! Ha 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 ha! Yes! Oh, I think that's the power gem, actually. Basically, long story short, Magus wasn't the kingpin of this, it was actually Thanos the entire time! Surprise, surprise. Mining complex. Who did I used to use? Yeah, Wolverine. Attack power. Which should help because Wolverine is surprisingly weak. Yeah, these things take more like three hits without the power gem. Makes that fight really annoying. Those have got to be evil Doctor Stranges. But you never fight one as like a full-on boss, so I never have a health bar with a name. Yeah, almost got me. Last try. Okay. Evil thing! There is a boss of him. Oh. Poison gas. Is all get out. Needed that. Can't get that. That little air dive thing is something I was stuck in. You can't cancel out of that. So let's just jump, 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 jump. Oh gosh, I just remembered who the boss fight is. That. Alright. Well, as great as this game is, and as much as I could go on playing it, I really do need to call the end of the stream. This section will be highlighted out and uploaded separately to YouTube as well. So, we'll go ahead and call it a night here. But let's see, tomorrow, like I said, the highlight's going to be Mega Man 7, so not tomorrow, gosh, I keep doing that. Thursday, the highlight's going to be Mega Man 7. We are going to be playing Mui Mallard and Cold Shadow, as well as Mary Shelley's Frankenstein along with it, but Mega Man 7. Then Friday will be the Mega Man X Trilogy, and then we will be just one step closer. Yeah, so Thursday, I'll be back. Same time, 7 p.m. Eastern. Anyone that hasn't done so already, give a follow to MarcusRaven86 on Twitch as well as on Twitter for stream announcements. And if you're watching on YouTube, feel free to come by during the actual live stream. We always have fun in the chat. So, it's been great. We will move on Thursday, now that I'm saying it right. So, I will give you guys a little post-show to rock out to, and I will catch you on Thursday. I have to keep saying it to make sure I get it right. So, bye-bye!